Hello folks, welcome back. In this demo, I will show you the most useful commands of Microsoft Teams command bar. Commands are shortcut for performing common tasks in Teams, like update your status, go to specific channel, show your recent files, and save messages, and many more. So stay tuned and let's jump right into the video. I'm in Microsoft Teams. You can access the command bar from the UI from the top and click on it and it will show you all the commands, or you can hit the control forward slash on your keyboard and you will see all the command. So the first command I want to show you is the file command. So forward slash file, this will show you all the files in your tenant. So the files in Microsoft Teams, the file in SharePoint, the file you have worked on anywhere or even OneDrive. So it will show you all the files and you can click on any file and go into the file details and open the files. This is a really easy way to go to your recent files from within the Teams. I clicked on one of the file and you can see it's a PowerPoint slide. It opened inside the Teams. The next command I want to show you is how to get to the shortcut keys menu. So if you click on the command bar forward slash and type keys, it will take you to the keyboard shortcut menu. So you can see there are general, navigation, messaging, meeting calls and calendar keys available. These are all the shortcut keys which you can use to improve productivity at your workplace, and you can easily get things done inside the Teams. For example, the show commands menu shortcut is control forward slash, which you can see here. The next Teams command I want to show is what's new. So if you do forward slash and type what's new, this will take you to the page of Microsoft Teams where they do all the announcements. So all the latest updates on the Microsoft Teams are announced here. So you can see on June 26th, there is an update. On June 19th, there is an update. And also on the June 15th, there's an update on the Meet Now or later. And you can see the history of the Teams, what feature they have rolled out already. This is a really handy command, so you can stay on top of it. So the next command I want to show is forward slash save. So you will see all the saved messages. I don't have any saved message, so I will go back to the Teams. And here I can select one of the message and click save this message. So this message will be saved. I can go back to the team and hit forward slash saved. And when I click enter, I will see all the saved messages here. So if you have any important messages which are placed on the team and you want to save it, or any document, attachment or email coming into Teams, you can save them. Next one is help. So if you want to seek any help, you can click forward slash help. It will take you to the help page of the Teams. This is where you can ask a question. For example, I'll say, how do I share my screen, for instance, and hit enter. Now this will take me to a result page where I can see a lot of information how you can share your screen inside Microsoft Teams. Again, this is really handy if you don't know anything or about any feature, you can easily get to the help. Next one is to open a pop-up chat window. So you hit forward slash in the command line and type pop, and now you can select a person name who you want to chat with in a pop-up window. So you can select the person name. Now you can easily do a chat in pop-up window. This is really a new feature of Teams rolled out recently. Once done, you can close the pop-up window. Next one is mention. So forward slash mentions. So if you've been mentioned in somewhere in the chat, in the Teams, inside any channel, you can view the history here. So the next one is setting up availability status. So you can set it to DND, which is do not disturb. So forward slash DND, it will set your profile to not disturb, that you're not available so other team members are aware that you're not available. And same as you can set it to forward slash away, for example. So you can try forward slash away. Now you are away and other people can be notified when they try to reach you, and then you can set it back to available. So another important one is go to. So let's say I'm inside everyone team and I want to go to project board team. Imagine you have thousands of teams, so you can type forward slash go to and select a team you want to go to. You will be automatically navigated to that team area of Microsoft Teams. That's it for today. You have learned how you can use Microsoft Teams shortcut commands to improve productivity at your workspace, and you can get things done really easily and quickly. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any queries related to Microsoft Teams or anything related to Office 365, post in the comment section below. I review my comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer them. Thank you.